Every successful business has a proven strategy for making profit. The same is true for real estate. Today we're going to go over some strategies that most successful real estate investors use to make a lot of profits in their real estate deals. The first part of the strategy, and the most important one, is finding the property. The most important part of the process is buying the property right, making sure that you're building that equity from the beginning. The good rule of thumb is buying a property that's anywhere from 70 to 80% of the repair value. You want to make sure that you find the property with equity to begin with. Distress is fine. You're going to put a couple of dollars. You're still going to have a good margin, but buying the property at a good price is the number one and most important thing you do when investing in real estate. Building the equity, or like most investors think, is done at the beginning of the process by finding the right property. Two is financing, one of the most important parts of real estate investing. There's so many options out there. There's more options than ever. Understand the difference between a bridge note, short-term lending, and long-term lending, conventional, semi-conventional type of lending. Make sure that you understand your strategy from day one. You're buying a distressed asset. Chances are you're gonna need a short-term loan, also known as a bridge note. And you're totally okay with paying higher interest rates because you're getting the distressed property at a discount. And once you rehab the property and you're done with that, you're gonna move to long-term, better rates. And number three is finding the experts that are gonna help you with this transaction. You already have the property, you already have the lending. What are the experts that you're gonna need to get your property up to par? You know, you're gonna need a roofer, you're gonna need a plumber, you're gonna need property management company to help you maybe allocate these people. Put the team together right away. The minute you have the property on the contract, put your team, or actually build out your team before you even do the transaction. Number four is your exit strategy. Are you gonna flip it within 6 months? Are you gonna rent it long-term? Are you gonna flip a rental after a couple of years? Are you gonna do corporate rental, Airbnb? What is the best rental strategy that you're gonna do? Get to know this, understand this before you buy the asset. Make sure that you have a plan in place. If you're gonna go with a specific niche like Airbnb or corporate rentals, make sure you meet with the right experts. Study the subject, understand it very well, but you always have to have your strategy before you even buy the property. You need to know what you're gonna do with this asset, short-term and long-term. Last but not least, rinse and repeat the process. You know, what is your goal long-term? How many properties you wanna have? How did the first transaction went? Did it go good? What things do I need to adjust moving forward to make sure that my second is, and third and fourth and fifth transactions are exponentially better and better and better as time goes on. Rinse and repeat the process, keep building properties until you have enough properties to retire and you don't have to work anymore. This is Jorge with Graystone Investment Group, where you invest and we do the rest.